Welcome back to Tornby, Denmark. We're here for the VoIP Defender World Junior Curling Championships 2016. We will bring you live coverage from the Kastrup Curling Hall for this evening's draw. My name's Sander Ulvaag, and I'm joined by our extraordinary expert, Alison Kraviasa. Good evening.
Good evening, Sander.
Well, for our last game of the men's round robin, we'll have a wonderful battle between two great curling nations. USA and Switzerland are on the cards for our broadcast. Both teams already qualified for the playoffs, but the outcome of this game and the rest of the session will determine who's in the 1-2 and who's in the 3-4 page. We'll take a look at the standings before this session gets underway, and we'll see USA, Canada, Scotland and Switzerland already qualified. USA at 7-1, Canada, Scotland and Switzerland currently at 6 wins, 2 losses. Norway and Sweden at 4-4 and will keep their spot with a win. Losing might bring Russia into a tiebreaker situation, as we see them sitting on 3 wins, 5 losses. Denmark and Turkey will be relegated with only 2 wins. Korea, the lucky loser, as they keep their spot by hosting next year's World Junior Curling Championships. Lineup for USA today, we'll have at lead Alex Fenson, second Mark Fenner. Throwing third stones, we have Thomas Howell, and the team is skipped by Corey Dropkin. Alternate, Quinn Evanson, and the team is coached by Wally Henry.
For Team Switzerland, at lead we have Michael Probst. At second we have Patrick Wichonke. At third we have Romano Meyer. And skip is Yannick Schwaller. The alternate being Simon Glur. And the team coach is Bernhard Wertheman.
Well, that's the lineups for you. And we see the Tornby Curling Club logo. This five-sheet curling club does actually have an adjacent two-sheeter just next door. As this would be Denmark being honored. That was Danish national anthem, Der er et yndigt land. There's a lovely country. Denmark, the hosts, and being honored here for the last draw. Teams just getting ready, finding their brooms. I'll have a few practice slides. And I think everyone's a bit excited when we were looking at the TV schedule, seeing USA, Switzerland, and the very last game. We'll see USA throwing red stones, Switzerland yellow. Switzerland having won that last one draw at practice. They will have the hammer, or also called last stone advantage. And we expect to see great things here. Although both teams qualified, this game could determine who ends up in the 1-2 page and who ends up in the 3-4. And I'm sure that's enough motivation for this game, Alison.
Yeah, not only that, but it definitely is going to give them that added confidence and momentum coming into the playoff rounds.
We'll try and keep you up to date with what's happening, all depending on the other results of the session. As we see Corey Dropkin and Yannick Schwaller just making their way down to the house here, ready for the first stone of the game. Here is Alex Fenson, lead for Team USA with the intern draw.
You're pretty close, coach.
Line's good. Tom.
Looking for the center guard here, so not wanting to play this too easy. And then we see Switzerland putting up the corner guard. We'll already have some action here in the first end. Michael Probst, lead for Switzerland with the intern. Looking to put this corner guard on the board side of the sheet. Well, we'll see the sheet swing a lot less going that way. Could see them put the corner on the other side where it's more swing, but then again, easier to come after it.
Yeah, don't need to bring your guard that close to the rings. Then again, I'm not sure this corner guard is going to be that effective for them right now, seeing as how the center guard and the corner guard are actually quite close together. Not leaving a heck of a lot of space in between to draw around.
Keep going, Tom.
Let's take another peek.
Hard, Tom.
Definitely
hard, Tom.
With that left-hand side being so curly.
It
doesn't really matter. It's quite tight on that left-hand side. Only keeping that right-hand hand open.
Really great draw.
Okay.
Almost fully wrapping that one around and only being top eight. Decent curl.
Seemingly a little curl that way today.
Yeah.
Alex Rallern just not quite sure what they want to do with this second stone. Either come around that corner guard or freeze the shot stone. I think they have elected to just come around the corner. Really not playing around here. Calling some aggressive shots early on. See how this bends towards the board. Oh, actually over curl and just clipped that guard. I think the line was good though, just a bit shy for weight. That would probably only be a best top 12.
Yeah.
Guard. And
you'll see USA just throw the center guard here, knowing that Switzerland will have to try and open things up. Not wanting to be too fancy with it. Just throw a center guard and leave Switzerland to do all the work. Mark Fenner throwing second stones for the Americans. Enjoying a great week here in Tornby. Comes a little too close to those tight guards. Just making this run peel a little bit easier for Patrick Vichonke, second player for Switzerland. Looking to clear off some of the center guards here, open up everything. That's pretty good, actually. Guess both those yellows moving to the left.
Double corner guard guarding the edge of the 12 foot.
We'll see if that comes into play at some stage of this end. We'll see Corey Dropkin just putting the broom just about middle of the 8 foot to put up the center guard. So it does swing a little less. I think both teams knowing that, though. USA having played here against Scotland on Monday in the second draw of the men's competition. Switzerland just playing there yesterday, actually, against Korea. So, but if anything, maybe Switzerland having the better call of the ice. I think it's stayed quite consistent.
Yeah, all week it's been fairly consistent for us. We've had the inside information and been able to see every single draw of what these sheets are doing. And since we started on Sunday, it's been pretty consistent. Weight seems to be the same as it was at the beginning of the event. Our ice makers are doing a fantastic job keeping the ice conditions.
That looks like a lot. It should be good.
I took more for my draw, so. Okay. 95, 4.
95, 2, 4, 0 would probably be close.
Thomas Howell. Third for USA. 2013 World Junior Sportsmanship Award winner.
Line's good.
Clean.
Weight's close.
Whoa, just clean.
Where? Line's good.
Gotta let it sit. Gotta sit.
Okay. Gotta sit.
Right next to that.
It's a nice, nice right little thing to do at the World Juniors.
Yep.
All the athletes will vote. And just vote for who they think should be this year's Sportsmanship Award winner, really, and get a little trophy and everything. It's a nice.
It's a real honor.
Oh yeah.
So, okay. Three, four, two, okay.
Ramon Amayer. Throwing third stones. We saw him throw fourth rocks last year.
Pat,
and this team got the silver medal in Tallinn, Estonia. Yannick Schraller doing some fantastic legwork to get everything going.
Yeah, so just... sticking that shooter, the yellow, sorry, to stay for a center guard.
Thomas Howell, having played two World Junior Championships before, once in 2012, and of course in that year in Sochi, 2013. He's improved on his round-robin record already before this game. With
whoa.
Seven wins, one loss.
Let it sit.
Where?
Tight.
Having his best round robin record back in 2012 at 5-4, not making the playoffs.
Missing that back red. Just calling the sweep, but trying to get the curl with the sweeping motion. But not a terrible result by rolling the guard off, but the U.S. is just going to put another one up there. And it's looking pretty messy up there. Not really... too sure which draw path he'll take, should he need to.
If it's going a little deep, you want to half bury it around the guard.
A little bit of a guess, but...
we don't want to show him that side.
Yeah, we don't really want to show him that side.
We shall see.
So here is Skip of Team USA, Corey Jopkin. His fourth appearance at the World Juniors.
Tom!
Named alternate last year, although he came on to play pretty much every game.
Whoa!
Two.
Gotta
stop.
Whoa!
It's pretty deep.
Gotta stop.
It's pretty deep.
Let it stop. That's all right, Cor.
That's fine.
Pretty good center guard.
That ball's probably pretty tough anyways.
Yeah. It's good. Okay. It just breaks.
Not bad. Yeah, it goes.
Yeah.
Evan, snake wood.
So shy, Sam.
I'm in the door. Ja, also outlaying so könnt's noch. Aber ist das auch schwierig. Find der gut, ja. Lange das?
Ja, ich glaube es. Ich darf sicher einen Fieber
ankommen. Ja. Am Sack, ja.
Lieber dann auftatschen.
Okay. Ja, ist gut. Weißt du, wenn nur sonst wenn nur hier klatscht, ist nicht so schlecht.
Aussen ist gut.
Mit dem gut
aussen
behalten.
Ja,
ist geil.
Ein bisschen weniger.
So it looks like we will have the intern draw from Yannick Schwaller.
Let me try hardliner.
Let
bisschen Hardline.
Ja, wir müssen recht mit der Richtung arbeiten.
Gut.
Okay. Yannick, son of Christoph Schaller, the Olympian. Also his uncle, an accomplished curler. Andy Schaller, also on that Olympic team. Back in 2002. And you got bronze. Comes past the guards here.
Looking like a really, really
round
good one.
Everything. Gets to the back four. That's a fantastic draw.
Yeah, great result. It's not an easy port to come through.
That's a pretty good line call as well. To get all the way in there.
Nice shot. That's really
good. Say.
Yeah, what a great draw that was. Does slip a little bit behind the tee, but
it's pretty hard to get.
Yeah.
Pretty hard to get there with top four.
Yeah, what a heck of a draw.
Forcing Corey Draken to follow that draw down. Okay. If we can ever put this frozen on the yellow, or even leave it a foot higher, it'll be pretty hard for Switzerland to score. Pretty sure his sweeper's going to stay close for this one.
Yeah, I would think so.
Big breath here, Corian, before kicking out the hack.
Yep, seven.
Yep. Pulling seven, that would be tee line weight. Wide for line, perhaps, here. I'm not sure if this is going to curl enough.
Yeah, sweeping for line to try and get it to curl a little bit more.
And with that, all of a sudden, a chance for Switzerland to score two. The question is it easier to draw or play the little hit and roll?
Hard to tell.
Looking at both options. I believe that Yannick is saying, well, let's play the draw, and if we come off this wide red one, that's okay too. Sometimes we see players, they call two shots in one. It doesn't necessarily always work out, so it's quite important for Yannick to just focus on the draw. And leave the wick for as an option rather than a call, so to speak.
Yeah, definitely don't want to overthrow this.
Last stone of the first end. Yannick Schaller looking for a skip stews, setting up his team with a very nice first draw. Probst and Vichonke on the sweep. Now Vichonke on really back and forth, really, to get this passed. Oh, just going to rub the guard, but still going to be good enough to slide into the forefoot.
That was close.
Wow, that's two stunning draws by Yannick Schaller. Skips deuce indeed. As you see, Vichonka almost going a little too hard for the curl there. Probst able to save it in the end. Yannick Schraller's really come to play this evening. Looking fired up. With two great shots and just a fantastic start for Switzerland. A little fist bump in the air there. After one end, Switzerland 2, USA 0. And USA, of course, will have last one advantage for the second end. That's pretty tough to swallow if you're American. You're pretty much ahead in the whole end. And then all of a sudden, Yannick Schwalle making a perfect draw to the back four. One miss from Corey and a score of two.
Yeah, that's just goes to show you how much an end can change. It's never a guarantee. We had quite a few ends this past event where it's really, really flip-flopped.
Mikael Probst here, along with Romano Meyer and Skip Yannick Schwaller, all in the military together. In what we could call the sports military, where they are allowed to go on ice every day. And having basic military training. But we had 5 weeks of military training, and they're just in a 13-week period now of only curling, alongside Swiss team Peter de Cruz, picking up a lot from them. Just spoken to the boys, quite happy to learn from de Cruz.
I think it's pretty safe to say that both teams on the ice right now are extremely fit. Both spend a lot of time working on their physical fitness.
Yeah,
some really excellent sweeping.
Well, the USA, part of their high performance program in USA, and the Swiss team also getting funding, of course, being in the military. I'm sure they're sure they got some training to do.
I don't think they're sitting on the couch much.
A nice little setup by Probst. Puts that first on top of the 8 foot and throws the center guard. Interesting call here from Corey Dropkin, looking for the tick shot, the weagle. Yep. That's what's been named by a lot of people after seeing Rachel Holman and your former teammate Allison's Lisa Weagle implement this shot many times over the last few years.
And he will do a pretty good job at it. Does push it behind the corner, but
I wasn't even sure if that was the side he was going for.
I don't think so.
But in the end, two corner guards and the center guard off the center line, so not too bad there. Something to work with for USA for sure.
Does choke off a bit of the draw around that corner guard, though. Will have to come a little bit deeper than they probably want. Mind you, we are appealing this, though.
So. Well, that's a great thing about the Swiss side. They're very good at the aggressive offensive play. But when they have a lead, they're pretty greedy. They don't allow too many stones in play.
Yeah, just a little too thin. Needed that one to actually curl a little bit more.
Now, Mark Fenner being asked to play a little hit and roll off this yellow stone. Try and roll in behind the other one. Just hoping that Switzerland makes a mistake and at some point USA will be able to draw around that corner guard they have on the opposite side of the sheet.
Whoa! Whoa! Close! Tom! Whoa! Alex, close! Tom!
Tom!
Tom! Tom!
So straight. All right, that's fine.
Good.
Good. Yannick Schwaller calling for a 9. I believe that would be 9 seconds hog to hog. Bit of a normal weight, I'd say.
Yeah, most teams would be around the 9 seconds hog to hog for about a normal. Some teams electing to throw a little bit less than that for their normal weight, but it is very team specific. Something the team would agree upon beginning when they first form the team is the kind of the first couple steps of figure out who's playing what. Okay, now we're on the ice. Let's learn what our weights are, what our lines are.
Not quite being able to make that hit and roll, and again Switzerland with a chance to hit and lie too. Roman Meyer. Enough to lie two there. Roman Meyer winning the Youth Olympics for Switzerland, playing second back in 2012, Innsbruck, Austria. Thomas Howell also participated in that Youth Olympics 4 years ago, also playing second. With a 7-1 record. Well, they won seven games straight, and then they lost to Italy in the quarterfinals.
Ooh, that was pretty close to that guard. Looking a little baffled by the line call.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Well, you're better off rolling too far than sitting center line side, because you kind of tempt. Well, Switzerland's going to have to come after this on outside the corner, and it's very hard for them to roll back in. It's going to allow more space for USA to come around the corner if they're wanting to do so. Leaving that other yellow unattended, top 12. Exactly, I'll see a nose hit, and with only one stone in the house, maybe USA wanting to take that risk to come around. We'll see. Yeah.
Just leaving it even with that yellow so that there's no slash opportunity. If you do come in a little bit deeper, the Swiss team is going to be very easily be tempted into throwing, as we can see the slash on the side yellow. So rock placement on this being very important in order to try and generate your deuce.
Where? Top yep, eight. Yep. Yes.
Whoa. Wait's good.
Whoa.
Close out.
Cooch. Whoa, Alex. Cooch. Cooch now.
It's there.
Right here.
Sink it.
Yeah, let's go. Yep. Go. All right, get there.
That's not buried, huh?
Pretty good weight there. But as you heard Thomas Howell say, not completely buried. There's a good chance for Switzerland to come after it.
About half a rock, give or take. So here's Switzerland. Believe I heard a hack in there, so just going to try and come down to that red one with hack weight and push it through the rings. Be able to see how much this is going to move.
Pat.
Bravo, Mitty.
A very nice hit and roll by Yannick Schwaller. Very much in control of the line call, using that directional sweeping very well.
And Jungs.
You hear them just calling out names for who to sweep. Makes it very easy as a sweeper.
You're pretty close.
You hear your name, you sweep. You hear the other guy's name, you stop.
Yeah.
Makes it very easy. Problem is teams that have two players with the same name and so on.
Yeah, but I think that's when nicknames come in.
We won't be able to out-count that.
We might have to go under theirs.
What else is there?
Go this way.
We can try to do that. Okay.
Because otherwise he's just going to freeze, I think.
Okay. If we go this way, curls it crap to him.
You can come across the face, that's fine.
I don't know how straight it's going to go.
I do have a few nicknames that they've listed here, but I don't think Thomas is very original. We've got Tom.
Oh, boy.
But we have a Cooch for Mark Fenner.
Yeah, I've heard that. They use that all the time for line call.
Yep. And Ziggy for Alex.
Ziggy?
Ziggy.
Rolling to the left. Yeah, control.
Like Ziggy Stardust or David Bowie? Or?
I don't know. Yeah, it's something we can ask later on.
Maybe. Or maybe it's Ziggy and the Cockroaches, a cartoon. Not sure if you remember that. But I digress. Corey Dropkin looking for the hit and roll here. If he doesn't make the roll here, there's a big, big chance he'll be forced. So he's wanting to find some cover with this one. Doesn't quite seem like he has done that, and that red stone's fully in the open. If Switzerland makes the hit and stick here, Corey's going to have to take his 1 point in this end.
Not a bad result, though. Important to stick your shooter into the rings on this one so that it does force the American team to hit for their one or draw to the four, should they choose. We have seen that happen this week. I believe it was the Korean team.
Yes, that didn't work out.
Did not work out, no, but it was a very gutsy call.
Board.
I believe it was the second end as well. It was pretty early in the game, but he felt pretty confident in throwing that draw, and all the more to him. But
it's important for a skip to throw the shot they're most comfortable with, I guess.
Absolutely.
Well, we're down to the last stone of the second end here between USA and Switzerland. Corey Dropkin having to play a nose hit to score one here.
Clean. Tom. Tom.
Calling on Tom to get some curl. Runs a bit straight here. That's going to be enough to stick around the 8 foot. USA scores one. So after two ends of play, we'll see Switzerland lead the game 2-1. And the Swiss boys have done quite well. Scoring two, forcing USA. Now getting the hammer back for the third end. And I don't know about you, Allison, but I'd quite like to figure out what's happening elsewhere in the Kastrup Curling Hall today.
I was thinking the same thing.
Force is fine.
On sheet A, we have a matchup between Korea and Sweden. Sweden taking two in the second end, so they will lead 2-0, with Korea having hammer in the third. Sheet B, we have Canada versus Russia, both exchanging 1 point, so it is tied 1-1 with Canada having hammer in the third end. Sheet C, we have Scotland versus Denmark. Scotland taking 2 in the first end, then giving up a 1, so they will lead 2-1 with hammer in the third. Norway versus Turkey. Norway taking a 3 in the first end, then giving up a 2, so they will lead, though, 3-2 in the third end with hammer.
Line's good. Line's good. Drive is through.
Nip through.
Paddy, I'm straight. No more paddies now. No more paddy. Drive is through. Yeah, duifer. Must duifer as the road.
Nogli, Pat. See you, Nogli,
Pat.
Nogli, Pat.
Hey, turn, Chris.
What's up, Rebu?
Sorry.
Line's good.
Five.
Cooch.
I think it's there.
Cooch.
It's all there.
Six.
So, coming around the center guard here.
Overline.
We'll see Switzerland be quite aggressive, even with the 1 point lead. They'll put up that corner guard.
On the four, I have to take shot.
Really nice. First two rocks.
The Nurkish guard.
Okay.
Keep going.
Yannick Schaller just asking his teammates if they like the freeze. It's a bit of a classic opening to a curling end. This one's run a bit straighter here. I think Mikael Probst just throwing this one just a little bit inside out, but Vichonka able to put it back on the right line. Just being a little bit heavy though, so bouncing off. At least pushing that red stone slightly in the open.
Guys like this.
Whichever angle's better.
I think you can get to that spot. I'm gonna go this way though.
I don't mind this side.
Mark Fenner throwing 94% so far this game. Looking to come down on that top yellow.
We're bumping.
Whoa, Tom. Yep. Whoa. Good.
It's pretty good.
Ain't no things wrong with that. Does fully get it around that red guard. Patrick Vichonka, throwing 100% so far this game.
Easy.
Not too shabby.
Okay.
And with Switzerland having Hammer here in the third end, there's no need for those center guards, so just peeling it away.
Tom!
Tiny ad. Keep going, Tom, keep going, Tom. Tom, keep going. Gotta keep going, Tom. Let's go. Go.
Whoa! Where?
Just really high.
Yeah, close.
Realizing whoa, that he's nothing. A little light and tight.
Nothing.
Okay. Not the best combo.
No.
Perhaps.
No. But doesn't overcurl that much. However, leaving the guard that high, it does enable Switzerland to get at those rocks in the forefoot quite a bit easier.
It doesn't seem like the Swiss boys are too afraid of putting stones in play.
No, probably realizing that this is a good chance for them to get another one in, since their guard is quite a bit higher than they would have wanted. Romano Meyer, hard on the brush to try and get some curl.
Well, Dutch has pushed the red ones back a little bit.
I think this is good though.
Both the elves in the open. There's no automatic double for USA though.
Good board!
Let's make this good.
Yeah, sounds good, Tom.
Looking for the hit and roll off the Yellowstone closest to the center line.
It cuts at the end.
I think it'll be close.
Okay.
Enjoying a good start here, Thomas Howell. 94%.
Pretty close to one.
Yes. Clean. Clean. Cooch. Whoa. Whoa. Alex. Yes.
Al.
Yes. 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 Whoa, roll it.
That's a very nice little hit and roll from Thomas Howell. Good line call, too, by Corey Dropkin.
Not bad.
Court. Okay. It's good. Yep. It's good to feel here.
Romano Meyer throwing up board weight.
Oh, coming around the guard here very nicely. And we'll be able to push those red stones back a little bit. Very nice shot indeed. USA still lying one, but a couple of yellows in there as well.
Yeah, pushing those two reds to the back, so that will be a problem area for the USA. Just making sure that they don't jam on those back ones.
Said we're gonna put this top yellow in jail if we play this.
Yeah. You can see it like half. I can see more than half.
I kind of like hitting that, don't you?
I do. Oh yeah.
Can we hit nose and just lose the back one?
I kind of like that. Even if you hit just offside nose.
What does he do, right?
You guys like that?
Kind of like hitting this one, don't you?
I'm just going to have a bit of a discussion here.
We've got over half on the outside. Yeah, that's not bad, is it?
I've got more than half.
Even if you play this. What's he going to do?
I like
He's going to come down to here, ain't he?
No, he's probably hitting this, right?
He's trying to hit that and roll that. Over.
I don't know if I like this, because that gives them just the hit and roll over.
We're putting this in jail if we do that.
Yeah. Should we do this?
I kind of like it. Like, if ours is full open,
we can lose that back one. It's really good.
Yeah.
You got to throw it a little harder.
We got to throw at least control.
I think it's control. Just here.
Okay, let's do that.
I think just off nose and you lose that back.
Because it'll cut this way. It'll cut. There's no doubt about that.
You guys like this?
Yeah.
Putting that stone in jail.
I haven't heard that one before.
No, not me either. I was hoping you would enlighten me.
No, sorry, I can't. I'm assuming he's talking about crashing them on the back, but
is that a lock?
Locking them?
I don't think so.
Another metaphor for jail?
Just
locking them in the back? Maybe?
Hair solid.
Yep.
Close. Yep.
Clean.
Whoa.
Hair solid.
Close.
We did see the call, though. Thomas Helm's going to try the nose hit on this Yellowstone top eight. Won't mind too much if they take off one of their back reds. Will not do so, but I think they're quite happy with that result. A lot of reds in there. And if you know what putting a stone in jail means, please tweet us at hashtag WJCC. 2016, or if you have other questions or other fun facts, anything you'd like to tell us, please do so.
Wann müssen wir hinten oder da?
Hinten da nicht das Dümmste.
Ich auch nicht. Vögel. Ist gut.
Haben wir mal.
Yannick Schwaller just calling down the front end here to have another look.
Der ist nichts.
Hä?
Der ist nichts.
Ja, definitely a lot of options.
Ja. Wann müssen wir die Nase haben, dass alle drei gehen?
Wir müssen gerade hinten anspielen.
Backline, zwar Backline ist nicht schlecht, wenn man den da hinten tappt
und selber anläuft. Das
finde ich gut, ja.
Nur Backline, ja.
Du kannst auch einfach ihn hinter 12 spielen. Eben,
ja, genau, ja.
Ja. Finde ich guten Call eigentlich. Ja.
So kannst du recht tappen mit
dem Rüschen. Ja, ja. Aber haben wir 4 Fuß, ist gut, finde ich gut. Hinter 12 Backline, ist gut.
Ist gut?
Ja.
Alright, so the call is to play this backline weight.
Für Backline, lange
Zeit. Try and punch that US shot out of the forefoot and I'm just going to roll to the left and try and sit on top of those two red stones in the back there.
Backline.
First caller we're looking at is just drawing into either top four, trying to level off those yellows or coming deep with a draw. But we're going to try and do both, removing the shot stone and also try and get the shooter to those back red stones and sit two.
Yeah, the good thing that what the U.S. team did on their last was hitting that top one really gains control, especially over that right side of the sheet. They're going to be able to use that to run into whatever the Swiss team ends up doing here. Big advantage for the U.S. team.
Well, that sounds pretty close.
That's
pretty good.
Yep.
Just wanting to maybe roll a foot deeper, but that's a pretty steep double angle.
I think I like that.
Board.
I think I like that.
You gotta be careful with this.
Even if you only roll to here, this is fine. Because you don't want to roll too far, because then this isn't here anymore, right?
Right here.
So automatic call here for Corey Dropkin to play the hit and roll off the yellow stone next to Alex Vanson's brush.
Board weight.
Gotta say I'm enjoying myself.
Hit and roll on top.
Had some interesting curling so far.
Yeah, I like this call. Again, you're gaining control over the top. If you were to make that slash now, your shooter's going to roll a bit, and the red that you would hit back would lie relatively open. So I quite like hitting this one and rolling over. Corey Dropkin.
Solid board, one up.
Skip for the U.S. Queen. Team, throwing close. 75% so far this game.
Close.
Whoa. Whoa. Mark.
Huge.
Mark. Mark.
Whoa.
Mark.
Whoa.
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 Well, that's an excellent shot by Corey Dropkin. I'd say that angle on the run on the top 8 zone looks pretty perfect,
perfect
right now.
Perfect.
That is, that's money.
Yeah. That is perfect roll.
You can see that if Corey Dropkin ever plays a hit on that top red stone, you'll see that yellow one.
Yep.
Fly out the back door.
No problems.
For them to lie six. So Switzerland's going to have to put another yellow stone in here somewhere. I think they're just going to draw top four here. I think they're trying to put up an angle here where even if USA plays a slash double, that yellow shot stone might go onto the back reds. And if USA makes that run we were talking about, this stone played by Yannick Schwaller will be in the forefoot for at least second shot. Well, Yannick Schwaller made two incredible draws just down this intern path in the first end, so should have a decent clue of what it's going to do.
It's geschlossen.
12.
Ich glaube, muss ja.
12.
Oh, nur länger.
8.
Linie gut.
Calling this.
8, 4, 4.
A little short, perhaps.
Head off. Head off.
Meyer out to help as well.
Really going to need to go.
Go, 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 go.
Hard, hard.
I'd like to outcount a few red ones. I won't do that. And I don't think Corey Dropkin needs to think too much about what he wants to do here. I think the call's fairly automatic. It's just about where to put the broom and what weight to throw.
That yellow could be now be a problem. Rock for them, not giving them that open draw to the forefoot to potentially bail out for his next one. So he's in quite a bit of trouble.
You want to do three through here? Three?
Two or three.
All we're thinking is the hole and how much it cuts.
Two should be fine.
I thought two originally. All right, well, if you think two is fine through the hole, we'll throw it.
I think we know the track because that's a come through.
Yeah, that's good.
I think two is like right here. I think two's like right here because I give you here for control.
You want to hit off nose on this side, right?
Just off.
Yeah. All right. Two should be good.
Here. Not quite sure what two or three means either, to be honest.
I mean, missing nose is fine. That's the pro
side. Me neither.
I mean, the high side's the pro side.
Well, the guard's on the high side.
Could it be 12 or 13 seconds from hog to T-line?
You guys like this?
Yeah.
I have no clue. Again,
just two.
If you'd like to enlighten us about these U.S. curling expressions, please tweet us at WJCC2016 as we see Corey Dropkin get ready in the hack for his last stone of this fourth end. Third end, sorry. It's very hard to get confused in all this excitement.
Yep.
As
Dropkin's
stone coming down the ice here. Needs to go past the guards, make this little run back. And I think he's close. That's pretty good. Would have liked to keep that stone top four. But it's enough to lie. Is it four, perhaps?
Four or five?
Five, I think. So putting some pressure on Yannick Schwaller to draw to the 1 foot. It's a good thing for Switzerland though. That one red spilling to the left wing does mean that he only really needs a good full 8 foot here to cut USA down to a score of one. So just needs to add a few feet on this draw. Pretty much the same draw, just going to have to go a little bit wider.
I think at this point I'd be pretty happy to just give up one.
We did see Switzerland go out firing in this end to get some stones in play. Maybe regretting to do that now. Last stone of the third end, Yannick Schwaller looking for the forfeit. Oh, sweeper's backing off it. How far is it going to go? Alex Svensson will try and sweep it as far as he can. I believe that's gone too far.
Ooh, wow.
And that's at least four. And, well, just four. Well, just four is a hard, harsh
smokes.
Expression in curling. Steal of four. USA, they'll lead the game 5-2 all of a sudden.
Where's Mark going?
Wow.
Get a drink. Huh? Get a drink.
You think it's my time race?
I don't know, I'm just thinking.
That's surprising, seeing Yannick Schwaller throw two perfect draws in the very same turn in the first end. Pulling up short with his first and adding a bit too much weight on his second draw on this end. Well, that made everything a little more interesting. And if we saw Switzerland putting stones in play in this end, I'm not sure what I'm expecting for this fourth end. Down three now, so quite interesting.
Right. Team USA has been really putting on the pressure.
We'll see the umpire just telling their teams to pick up the pace a little bit there. That was a few very interesting ends, of course, needing some discussion. And Alex Svensson will start us off here in the fourth end.
Line's
of course, the son of 2006 bronze medalist
top four.
Pete Svensson.
50.
Not very hard
to. Keep going, Tom. Keep going, Tommy.
Not very hard to see that is that is Pete Svensson's son. They're very similar.
Good sweep, guys.
Pete, of course, here this week to watch this team play.
Yeah, the resemblance is.
Uncanny.
Uncanny.
Head cut! Whoa!
Keeps confusing people.
Yeah, you're going to have to put your glasses on, that's for sure.
Tap!
Okay. Easy.
Okay.
Corner guards in play.
Tap!
Got room.
Weight's good.
Room.
7-8.
Yeah, 7-8.
Line to hair,
7-8.
Tight.
Room. Room.
Clean.
Room.
Whoa, Cooch. Cooch.
Room.
Cooch. Pete Svensson never made it to a World Cooch. Junior Cooch. Championship, but he did make it to 8 World Curling Championships. At best, grabbing a bronze medal. Certainly a good start to following his dad's footsteps. Playoffs at the World Juniors. Very much in contention for a medal.
Yeah, they're having a great week. It's been an extremely tough field here on the men's side. Some fantastic teams from all the countries, and they've had to be on their A game the entire week.
Yeah, it's a bit like a perfect storm, really. So many teams at their prime age, having a lot of teams having been to the World Juniors on a few occasions. And I think with a lot of these teams aging out this year, it might be a completely different field next year. As we see in the women's field, quite a lot of young teams. And you might just see the same for the women's in a couple of years when all those teams mature in terms of curling. But we do have four of the biggest curling nations in the world through to the playoffs on the men's competition. USA, Canada, Switzerland, and Scotland.
Mark Fenner making a really nice double peel.
Yeah, just a sliver
on his first, pushing that one into the rings, but
that's why I took more.
Yeah, no, I know.
Right now they're just going to look at throwing the slash on this one to get both of them to go away.
Only get the guard, but obviously that's the main objective.
That is the tolerance. Just got a message from USA Curling Twitter, and a nice little photo of father-son, the Fensons. And it is absolutely uncanny how much the two of them look alike.
I'd like to see a picture of Pete when he was 20. And compare. That could be interesting.
Yeah.
So if anyone has a picture of Pete Fenson when he was like 20, 21.
We would love to see it.
Yeah. Coach, Thomas Howell. Coach. The intern Peel. At some point, Switzerland's going to have to make a move. I think this might be the time. All right, I have the answer to our question about the stone in jail.
Do you?
Thank you, Joe Polo. Of course, a very accomplished U.S. curler. He's explaining us that a rock in jail means you cannot hit it out of the rings with one shot.
Uh-huh.
So kind of like a frozen rock.
Yeah.
Yeah. Weight calls 2 and 3 are normal and firm hit.
Thank you very much, Joe.
Does that mean weight call 1 means control, perhaps? If 2 is normal and 3 is firm?
I would assume 1, yeah, would be a nice control weight hit then.
Right.
2 and 3 getting a little bit firmer as you go up the scale.
Thank you very much, Joe Polo.
As we said, every team has their own unique way of calling weights and what they associate their normals. And so this U.S. team electing to say 1, 2, 3, 4 maybe type of system. instead of saying normal or up normal, which you would see about 90% of the teams, unless Jeff Stoughton had
nice weight.
But most teams, you will hear them say normal or peel.
Joe Polo, of course, Pete Svensson's second when they got that bronze medal in Turin, 06. I believe that's an American thing because I haven't really heard that anywhere else.
Number system?
1, 2, and 3 in the Rock and Jail and all that. You're Canadian. You should know. You're close.
I haven't heard it.
You're close to those guys over there.
Well, I've been living out of the country for 2 years now. Maybe it's new.
Okay. Completely out of date.
I'm behind the times. Okay.
So, Romano Meyer, I believe they called the freeze here on the intern. They should swing big. So you'll see Probst already on the sweep, maybe for weight, though. Working really hard, these boys. Trying to get it all the way there. This one pulling up really short. And they'll end up freezing the stone top 12 instead. We might just see USA play the hit and roll off the stone on the wing to lie 3.
That's the safest play, right?
I don't think we do. Yeah.
They control or normal?
I think normal's fine. But if you want to throw one, I'm okay with it.
There you go.
It's a long roll.
It's going to skid. I think we need to get this somewhat flat roll, so it's quite normal.
How much?
Normal.
Okay. It's gone dead up on here.
What?
You hit it anywhere outside, it's coming right onto here.
Yeah. I mean, my concern is leaving that there.
You hit it anywhere here.
You have to play that and it jams.
This isn't bad either.
Yeah, but if you hit it anywhere here, this is dragging dead onto here.
I just don't want to end up having that stuff with the yellow, and then this is in the house too. Two's okay.
So what are you thinking?
I'm just saying we have to be careful.
What about just peeling this?
We have to make sure that this is here to spill the yellow.
Because if we leave it here, and we have to play that gun.
This?
Okay. But if we do leave it here, this jams.
We're not gonna leave this here. Two.
Take an extra breath in the
house. We can't hit nose, that's all. If we do, we could be in trouble.
I don't think nose is the end of the world, Tom.
What?
I don't think nose is the end of the world. As long as we roll in for third.
It jams that gun, though. There you go.
Thanks.
We'll kind of wait.
All right, two.
So Corey Dropkin will play this little hit and roll off the winger. And just rolling in for shot to lie 3 here. It's pretty good. I think he will be trying to roll all the way to the center line.
Really having to work hard to try and get it to curl. But unfortunately just gets it on the wrong side of the rock.
Well, still, I don't think Switzerland has a whole lot of options.
Yeah.
Down to Skip Rocks.
We'll
see if it's possible to play a double on the reds. Does seem like it might just jam, though, onto the forfeit.
It does look like it drags straight back there, but we'll be able to see in just a few seconds.
I believe he's going to try and keep the shooter in the house, so roll that in, try and sit 2 yellows anyway. to kind of force USA to make a shot. So probably just trying to go across the face a little bit.
Smart.
Not throwing too much weight. Trying to split these yellows and at least get one redstone going. I'll do enough to roll that yellow shooter into the top 12.
Where's the best spot? Like right here.
Right there.
And does leave that redstone exposed.
I guess you can just try it. Control.
So Quarry Dropkin's going to have to stick around here.
Yep.
For not to leave a nose hit for two.
Control. Nose is fine. A little roll-in's not bad, you know. It is, yeah.
I think nose hit here will be enough for USA to lie to. Might just make sure to get a tiny nudge toward towards the center line. Though Mark Fenner on the sweep here to keep this one straight. I will overcurl, but does make the roll in behind the center stone. I think that's going to be just as good.
Yeah, that's not a bad result at all. No way for Switzerland to find their two. Even if they did run that top yellow and make some sort of double, their shooter won't be in the ring. So great shot by Corey. They are absolutely putting the pressure on this Swiss team. Last stone here in the fourth end. Really gonna have to work, get it by, and they do, and they will take their 1 point. But still, the United States with a pretty prominent lead of leading 5-3 now with Hammer going into the fifth end.
Good force. All right. Up 2. Right?
This is 3 and that.
Blank here is pretty good. Scoring's not bad, though.
So we just want to thank the U.S. Curling Twitter feed for sending us these fantastic photos. In case you're interested, it's at USA Curl. They've been putting up some fantastic comparisons and a teenage picture of Pete here.
Pretty fantastic.
Supporting a beautiful red coat and blue pants. I'm sure he'd be very happy that this picture is being passed around now.
You'll see Alex Svensson, the great start at 97%. It's Just made some good draws.
Where? Take a look.
We'll see. USA. He's drawing to the wing here.
Looks good.
Might look for a blank here, or at least keep the blank alive. And perhaps try and score on the 6-10 instead, trying to keep last on for the even ends. It'd be nice to be two up with Hammer at halftime for sure.
Yeah, it's always throwing to the side there. Always tries to tempt your opponents into playing to the wing. If you can get a miss, then more chances than not, you're going to be able to blank the end. Give you a very quick update on what's happening around us. Sheet A, so Sweden up 7-2 over Korea. Canada is up, Russia is up 2-1 over Canada at the moment. Canada having Hammer and believe that they're only in the fourth end right now. We have Scotland up 5-2 over Denmark. Scotland having Hammer now. And Norway up 8-2 over Turkey in the sixth end. Bit of a time difference in some of these games, if my updates are running correct right now. Patrick Vichonka still at 100% so far.
Well, I can tell you with those results you just told me, Allison, we would see USA and Scotland in the 1-2 page, while Switzerland would play Canada in the 3-4. And we would see Russia, Denmark, Turkey and Korea relegated. Norway and Sweden keeping their spot, but still early, of course. Mm-hmm. Things can change.
Lots of possibilities. Mark Fenner, second for Team USA.
Yes! Yes!
Averaging 97% so far this competition, in this game. Makes a very nice double peel.
Yes, I think he's looking for the slash, though, to spill a shooter as well.
Does get rid of two, but maybe set up for a double peel in the next one, depending on where we're going on this.
Well, Switzerland definitely not scared, looking at those two reds on the wing there. USA pretty much put them there to put some pressure on Switzerland, hoping that they would maybe play the hit out there and open things up, but Switzerland really wants to try and go for a steal or at least a force here. We'll come around the center guard, try and lie to this one though. We'll over curl. Well, I think the angle's okay.
We don't want to stick around there.
No, this is just going straight in there.
I like the feel.
Not sure if he said that loud enough for for the guys to hear.
He said it's just directly to us.
Yeah, pretty much.
I don't mind that.
Go down there and look. I don't want to stick on the T line.
I don't either. I'm okay with just off nose on the guard. I'd rather feel the guard, make them make a good guard.
We don't want to stick around back here. This is only gonna give them something to freeze on.
Yeah, I know, but then we play the run. Or if they don't make the freeze perfect, then we're doubling them out. Ours is sticking.
I mean,
we go for this. Just going straight in here.
We're shot. A freeze on.
I'm fine with that. You guys want that?
I like the peel.
Now we're in trouble.
But then we just rip.
I know, but I kind of like ripping now.
Wanna try it and clip this or no?
They're gonna make a better one.
Okay.
They have to make a better one, otherwise they screw.
You guys rather this?
We miss the run, we miss the run. Miss it high side.
All right.
He doesn't like those there. I don't know why. I said he doesn't really like them there, but.
You guys rather that?
Basically knows.
All right, so you say being a little bit cautious and they'll peel the guard.
Yeah, I didn't mind Corey's call.
No, not me either. Sitting on top there, being top four. Not sure if that would be such a bad thing, although now playing that run back, I'm not even sure what happened. You might have to... be able to see that again.
Pretty good. That's pretty good.
Something good happened.
Something good happened. There we go. He's running the guard back. He will clip those yellows.
Great shot.
Well, spill one red, one yellow. So it's a belying shot. And the shooter ends up on the side. That's pretty good, actually.
That's pretty darn good. Opening up the center.
For USA, at least a score here, that's pretty good. That's still a good chance for Switzerland to get the force in. Calling this halfway.
He's
putting up the center guard. Feeling like USA will probably look to peel it, unless they switch gears.
I like that. There's no harm. No, if we lose ours, it's fine. Right, so nothing bad here at all.
They're actually going to try the slash here, Allison. And run the center guard in and try and pick that yellow stone in the house.
Yeah. Might as well. If you're a little bit wide and end up just peeling the guard,
yep.
Then
yep.
That's great too.
Well, he's been playing some good curling here, Thomas Holt. Oh,
again, everything happening.
Spilling the house open. Very good.
Nice shot.
Wow.
Perfect.
We got everything going.
Everything. This is a really dominant game right now.
That is amazing. I'm afraid our ceiling's a little low for the overhead camera. I can't quite see everything. That's why we have our replay guy.
They are doing an excellent job.
And Switzerland just going to put up the center guard again. Didn't want to group these stones. USA might look for the double. They would surely like to blank this end. I think what Switzerland was looking for there is just to force USA to play the single peel and then probably come around that red corner.
Jam, does it?
I thinking, wait a second, what jam?
This looks a bit simpler than his first one. Let's see if he can make it. Just got it a bit too thick, and we'll sit right there. And that's pretty close to the center line now, so actually a good chance for Switzerland to come around it.
Yeah, as good as a chance as they have.
It's a pretty long guard, so I guess no need to put this one too deep. Maybe just top eight. He's saying six is good. Six is top four.
Yannick Schwaller. 72% so far this game.
Yannick Schwaller with Meyer and Probst in the military in Biel.
This looks quite light. Guys are going to have to work. Work hard at getting it. Oh man, are they ever working hard.
That was a good sweep. They couldn't really do much more than that.
No.
Just had to go and just kind of killed the line a little bit there with the sweeping. Probs going hard at the end to make it curl. Or was it Vichonke?
Vichonke. Yeah,
yep. Sorry.
Yeah, so of course, both sweepers to try and drag the rock a little bit further in, but using Patrick to try and get the direction to have it curl a little bit more behind that guard. Corey Dropkin at 78% so far. Having a little bit of an edge over Yannick at the moment.
Tom. Yes, hard, Tom. Hard, Tom.
Tom, hard.
Hard.
Keep going, Tom.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Cooch.
Mark.
Whoa, whoa,
whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa. Roll it.
Whoa,
whoa, whoa. 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 Fight.
Do not fight. Want to roll out here.
Sorry, Carr.
And they have.
We were way up. We were way up.
Yeah, Carr just maybe throwing a bit more weight than indicated. And... that makes it a little hard to call line. Obviously having to cash that one thicker with the extra weight. So Switzerland with an excellent chance to come around that guard again and try and get the force. Yannick Schwaller just threw this draw, so should have a pretty good idea of what it's going to do. So I'm having a bit of a trouble with in the third end with his draws. After having played two beauties in the first.
Yep.
All on this very same path.
Yep. Yep.
Probst trying to keep the line.
Party, party, bravo. Party, 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 party.
He's gonna have to work for it to get it further again.
Don't want to overbury it either. I think they've done quite well.
Yeah, I think they've managed to cover the majority of the rock, but...
yeah, I don't think you'll be blanking.
No, and I don't think you'll be stealing, though.
No, I'm not sure if that was ever...
No, but could put a little bit more pressure on Corey had it gone just a little bit further, but this is going to be a... pretty easy draw to the full 8 foot to take his 1 point.
For sure. So I'm hoping for a blank here in the fifth. Will not get it. But scoring one and being up three is pretty good too. Last one before the halftime break. Mark Finner and Tom Howell on the sweep. Just kind of cleaning this one in. Looking fairly happy with it. No problems there. Sweeper's delight as it finds the 1 foot. And after five ends of play, halfway there, USA with the lead, 6-3. We'll see both teams just head off the ice for a few minutes. I'll have a chance to talk to their coach and all the alternate players. Maybe fuel up on some snacks and some drinks. We'll be back shortly with some highlights from those first five ends and, of course, the conclusion of this last men's session here at the VoIP Defender World Junior Curling Championships 2016. Men's last round robin session. We have Switzerland and USA. It's Yannick Schwaller with the skips deuce in the first end after having played a beautiful draw through the part on his first one. The second one just as good. In the second, we saw Corey Dropkin, skip of USA, having to take his one. Makes the nose hit to stick around the 8 foot. After two ends of play, Switzerland up by one. Switzerland would really put some stones in play, play an aggressive end. Corey Dropkin left his little run back here to sit four. Really putting the pressure on Yannick Schwaller to make really the same draw he did in the first end twice. But this time coming up just a little hot. Alex Svensson on the sweep will bring it all the way to the back of the 8 foot. Good enough for a steal of four. USA would lead the game 5-2 after three. In the fourth end, Switzerland obviously looking for a multiple score, but being faced with two red counters, Yannick Schwaller just making that hit to score his single. And in the fifth end, we saw Yannick Schwaller make a nice draw around the guard to force Corey to make this 4 foot draw to score a single point. So after five ends, USA leading 6-3. And I believe we're underway here again. In the sixth end, Alex Svensson with the outturn draw. If you're just joining us, this is our World Curling TV live coverage of the VoIP Defender World Junior Curling Championships 2016. You're listening to myself, Sander Rølvåg, and I'm joined by my lovely and charming expert, Alison Krawiazik from Canada, although she's pretending to be Swedish.
I feel like as the week goes on, your compliments get more sarcastic.
Oh, no, they're always in
a positive way.
Oh, yes.
I don't know about
for
that.
For sure. Mikael Probst will throw the corner guard for Switzerland. He'll surely be looking to score a couple of points here in the sixth end. Would be a great time to do so. For the ones who had a keen eye, I think we just saw the umpire in the background there put up a score of 2 for Scotland. Could you please confirm that happened and maybe look elsewhere in the arena today, Alison?
I can indeed. Sheet A, we have Sweden up 8-2 over Korea. Sheet B, we have Russia taking a single point in the fifth end, so they will be up 3-2. Without Hammer in 6 now. We have Scotland up 5-2 over Denmark. We have Norway up 8-4 with Hammer in 7 right now. And that brings us to our sheet.
And with those results, and if those results stay the same way at the end of our session, we would see USA play Scotland in the 1-2 page. Switzerland would play Canada in the 3-4. Norway, Sweden would keep their spot. And Russia, Denmark, and Turkey all being relegated. While Korea at the bottom will keep their spot of the World Juniors, as they are the hosts of the Worlds next year in Korea. But as mentioned, it's not over yet. Many ends to go, so things can change. What I can tell you is if USA wins here, they will be guaranteed the top rank, first place.
Yeah, last game of the round robin, and they were definitely not slowing down. A lot of teams will tire, become a little bit mentally and physically drained as the week goes on, but The USA looking very much in control. Switzerland putting two very nice guards, making sure they're even so that there is no possible double attempt.
Clean.
Elf,
yep. Clean. Clean.
Tom.
Clean. Tom.
Get that flat boy.
Was close. Almost knocked the bottom of it. But he will just make the single peel. We actually do have a final game. Scotland just taking a victory over Denmark. Winning 8-2. After six ends.
Well, that is the minimum you have to play in round robin. Denmark only winning two games this week on home soil. Unless this guard will not leave a double for USA. Leaving those quite flat, and we might see Switzerland change up their call for their next stone.
Clean. Clean.
Got a lot of weight going down the sheet right now.
Well, you have to be sure, Allison. Not everyone is able to just tick it over like you.
Stop it.
If you didn't know, Allison is
known
for just catching a thin sliver when she peels guards, just to kind of gently push them through the boards. And that's what she'll be known for the rest of her days. Romana Meyer will,
thanks to you.
We'll change up the call here and come down onto the stones in the forfeit. Get to the face of the redstone and sit on top. I think that's the call, but won't curl enough and I'm just going to roll to the wing.
Okay.
Not terrible. But not amazing.
Guys!
They're gonna corner freeze our top four.
Stick, we want to peel out.
What do you guys think?
I think it's fine to stay, but if you don't want to, it's not the end of the world.
You're like, stick or peel out?
I'm just worried
as
about
as long
leaving.
As it's not gonna be in the way, we can stick.
Is it gonna be in the way? Do you like peeling?
I don't mind just running out here.
I would just get it out of there. You don't need to stick.
Taking a lot of
they're probably playing this next shot.
You know, team meetings, discussions here throughout.
Yeah, this game's running a little bit slower.
What do they do?
Canada, Russia also a little bit behind.
Yeah, we've
is it bad to peel though?
There's no time clocks for this event, but
teams
generally been quite efficient.
I don't think that's bad because I don't know
but
what
this being the last
the
session, maybe just things dragging out just a tiny bit more.
Plus, maybe I catch it real thin and we get
do you like
it?
Huh? I almost don't mind hitting it now.
You can't sit down there and tell me to feel and say you want to hit it. I'm kind of a fickle person. All right, let's do this then.
Oh.
Don't confuse your skipper like that.
Well, what are they going to do?
I don't know.
I don't mind this call
like
either, to be perfectly honest.
You think so?
Yeah.
Just peel it out, Carr.
Hit that one. Sorry, that's my bad.
You gotta hit something, y'all. I think both are okay.
Yeah.
I'd probably hit the stone in the house, though.
On the next shot, that's fine.
Do you like rolling in on this?
Oh, boy.
Yep, yep. Two guys.
And we will make the hit and roll out. Finally.
Throw the pocket machen.
Zwei Varianten.
Die zwei Varianten.
Ja, mit dem Pocket macht er den Nose, dann liegt er schon mal drei.
Stimmt.
Dann muss Freeze Roll kommen.
Stimmt. Draw liegen wir auf nur Third. Draw liegen wir nur Third einfach.
Was ist?
Draw sind wir auch nur Third, aber.
Ich weiß, aber macht er nicht auf dann.
Doch, doch. Ich finde beides okay.
Dann mit dem meinem ersten Dado.
Ja, ist gut, machen wir drauf. Gut.
Gut. Doppel oder was soll's?
Was?
Was? Vor der 4!
Vor der 4.
Sonst 60.
I think they're just going to draw around the guard here. Surely the easiest way of placing that yellow in behind cover rather than playing the hit and roll. But I think they'll only be lying third shot here, so there's a bit of risk involved. Does curl a bit less coming this way as well. Mikael Probst working really hard with the directional sweeping to get some finish.
I think he might have a pretty good chunk of that rock in the hack.
Hack like right here.
Almost all.
I don't think he's gonna curl a whole lot. Do you like this?
What's that?
Hack right here.
Yeah, it looks close.
I think Corey's voice is a little hoarse. And Alex is having a little bit of a hard time hearing what he's saying.
Hack, wait.
That's probably why he whispered to us what yeah. He thought of the strategy a couple ends ago.
Yeah, just realizing he wouldn't be able to speak loud enough anyway.
It's a tough week for your voice.
I remember I played my first international competition at the Youth Olympics. Well, European Youth Olympics, whatever that was, back in 2009. Screamed so much I lost my voice. I couldn't even make a sound for a couple of days.
Aww.
I was just flapping my arms like a crazy person.
Well, that's where hand signals are very important. In this case, for Corey, he's going to need to really make sure he's giving as much information to his sweepers as possible.
Well, this one not curling enough and actually moving all the reds about. That's a break for Switzerland. Through that one, maybe all full to the broom.
Yeah, Thomas really working hard to try and get that curl, but straight side and.
The hair straight, but this is just going towards the boards. So if you do that at all, it's not going to move at all, you know.
There we go. Perfect explanation from Alex Svensson. If you're just a little bit inside out, it's not going to curl on you coming this way. And I think we see Switzerland just coming around the corner guard again here. Just want to set top tee, lie for second and third shot, put the pressure on USA. Trying to deal with that shot stone on Yannick Schwaller's last rock.
Acht!
Itzli gehabt!
Achtung!
Adi! Adi!
Hopp!
Adi!
Verdammt!
Hey, bravo! Bravo!
Auf 4, Ti!
We're really needing to curl here. Gonna end up almost freezing their own yellow. It's not too bad there. But, not perfect. Maybe USA come after it.
We can do
this and give him two.
Normally, if there's enough curl, you could play hack weight here and try and sit on the face of it and get that yellow back stone off. But we did see Dropkin throw about hack weight down this line. Didn't move him very much. So
this looks pretty close.
Might just freeze, yeah.
All right. Sounds good.
Freeze tap even.
Get right here. Yeah.
As long as they have the line.
Okay.
Sounds good to me.
You like this, Allison?
Yes, I do. I don't think you don't need to throw a lot of weight at this. Should you roll into the open at all, you're probably conceding a two, freeze. No matter.
What do you guys want for weight?
If you roll off, but if he can stick his shooter and just kind of corner freeze on the top of that yellow, it's going to be probably just an open draw for Switzerland for their one.
Tom, clean.
Line's blocked.
Well,
line's good.
See where this one ends up.
Tom.
Mark.
Tom. No.
Mark.
Tom.
Let's get into it. Mark. Yeah.
Cooch. Cooch.
I think line's pretty good here. Sweepers are really only concerned about the weight. They're going to lock it on the yellow. That's a beautiful shot by Corey Dropkin.
That's really good.
Thought I'd make up for it.
I'm not sure skinnying the guard. I'm not sure it's there. Doesn't curl a heck of a lot going that way, so I guess we'll see from the other end how much we can see of that red, but that looks tough.
I'm going to have a proper look here in Switzerland to see if there's any way to score more than their one. You could say if that guard wasn't there, you'd be able to at least score two. But it is pretty much in the way. If they have enough room on the right hand side, they might come off. Make the double on the two top reds. I believe Switzerland has a second shot. So. So they're going to try this, I believe, Allison. They're trying to play the nose hit, maybe even touch inside on the top red.
Oh, sweetie.
The middle yellow should sit there. And then the top red should spin down and catch that stone back four. That's I think that's the theory, anyway.
Here we go. Here's a hack.
That looks tough.
That does look tough, especially for the straight side.
Might as well play the run back, if anything. Might be easier.
That's what I was thinking. If you're going hard for it, might be easier with the run, but here we go.
Yep, last stone, 6-10, Yannick Schwaller with the big shot. Well, this one's going to pass the guard by a mile, and that's a bit of a disaster right there.
Wow.
Steal of three for USA. That's nowhere close. Yannick Schwaller started off so well with two beautiful draws in the first end. And after that, just hasn't been quite on point. And this looking pretty tough for Switzerland. Now it's actually game over already. Nine shots of three and six ends of play. Not quite what we thought was going to happen in this game. Switzerland came out fairly aggressive and it didn't really work for them. USA had a great game. All right, so here you see the score line, 9-3. If you stick around, we'll get some highlights from this very interesting 6-end game. Just a bit unfortunate that we didn't quite get to see 10 ends of play here. Now we'll have a look at the women's competition and how the playoffs work. We'll have Canada play USA in the 1-2 page. The winner of that game will go directly to the gold medal game. The loser will drop down to the semi-final. And then in the 3-4 game, you'll see Korea face off against either Sweden or Hungary. And they'll play a tiebreaker game. The winner of that game will go to the semi-final and play the loser of the 1-2. This is the women's competition and how that's going to pan out. What's going to happen for the men's, we don't quite know yet. Obviously, a lot of games still in motion. USA will, of course, get first rank, winning that game over Switzerland. And elsewhere in the arena, we're seeing Canada leading 4-3 over Russia. We saw Scotland beat Denmark 8-2. We saw Sweden beat Korea 9-2. And looks like Norway is very much in control over Turkey with an 8-4 lead. And I will have the highlights for you for them from this evening game. First end in the last game of the men's round robin. Yannick Schwaller making a beautiful draw on his first one. The second one, not too shabby either. Just squeaking past the guard to score two. In the second end, Corey Dropkin facing two yellow counters. Will have to make the nose hit to score his one. After two ends, Switzerland up by one. In the third end, we're seeing Corey Dropkin's last stone. Making this crucial run back to sit four. Putting some pressure on Yannick Schwaller to make the draw to the forefoot. You'll see that Yellowstone top 12. That was his first draw attempt. On his second one, just adding a bit too much weight. This one slipping and slipping. Alex Svensson on the sweep will bring it all the way to the back eight. Enough for USA to steal four. 5-2 after three ends of play. In the fourth end, Switzerland really trying to score a couple of points back, but facing two US stones, Yannick Schwaller can't do much more than just play the nose hit to score one. And in the fifth end, we did see Schwaller make a nice draw around the guard, forcing Corey Dropkin to make a forfeit draw, which he does, bringing the game to a 6-3 lead for the Americans at halftime. In the sixth end, Corey Dropkin making a very nice corner freeze. Yannick Schwaller trying the hero shot, but not even close, giving up his steal of three. And with that, a final score after six ends of play, 9-3 in favor of USA. So with the games as they are now, Norway seemingly beating Turkey, Scotland having won against Denmark, Sweden beating Korea, and Korea with only that 1-point lead against Russia. But if things will be as they are, we'll see USA and Scotland in the 1-2 page, Canada and Switzerland in the 3-4, with Russia, Denmark, and Turkey being relegated, Korea keeping their spot as they're hosting the next World Juniors. I believe we have Corey Dropkin of USA ready for an interview with our lovely reporter, Allison.
Congratulations, Corey. You had a very dominant game. How much momentum does this give you going forward into the 1-2 page playoff game?
I'd say it gives us a good amount of momentum. I think this whole week's been a progression from the beginning. So, you know, we're just happy that we're in the 1-2 game. We still have unfinished business. We still got two more games or whatnot left to go. We're hoping that we can, you know, come out strong in the next one against whoever it is. And yeah.
Noticed, obviously, you've lost your voice a little bit.
Yeah, I have.
Is there any kind of signals that you guys use on the ice to help you get through this?
I think just usually we're like, because it's so loud in here, I feel like I'm screaming more than I ever do usually. So just pointing brooms at whoever I want inside and whatnot, and the guys are doing good on looking up and communicating everything for me, and so we're making it work.
So it's the first two U.S. teams to qualify together since 94. What does that mean to you guys and to everyone watching back home?
It's amazing. It's incredible. Just being in the playoffs, it's the first time for me, I think for Corey as well, being in the playoffs. And so we're just looking to make the most of it and hopefully come home with some medals.
Congratulations and good luck tomorrow.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Corey, can I just ask you
something? That was Corey Dropkin, quite happy for both the U.S. teams to come through to the playoffs. For scores, please go to wjcc.curlit.com if you want to stay updated and see what's going on with the rest of the games out there still in motion. We'll be back with more curling action tomorrow. And the playoffs, we'll have some broadcasts for you at 2 o'clock local time tomorrow, Saturday, for us at the World Curling TV. That's it for today. Join us again tomorrow.